In this video, I'll describe an approach to false negative investigations in Microsoft Defender for Office 365. These can happen when an attacker weaponizes a URL after delivery. Most often, you know about a false negative when a user submits an email as malware or phish. That signal quickly creates an incident and starts an automated investigation. The alerts indicate that the incident started with an email reported by user as malware or phish, and the incident graph shows information about the sender, email, mailbox, and recipient. There are a lot of ways to get started with your investigation, but I'd select Evidence and Response. This tab shows the email that the user submitted and helps you quickly track down any related emails. While you can see all the evidence here, select Emails to filter the list. Once we determine that the message is bad, we'll zap it, unless you've disabled zero-hour auto-purge like I have here. So, the email might already be removed from mailboxes. You can see we determine that the message is malicious. Because I've turned off Zap, the status is pending approval. You might also see running, prevented, or remediated. Select the email to see even more detail, like investigation and deliver details, email details, and any URLs and attachments it includes. You can go a step further by selecting Open Email Entity to view the email's timeline and our analysis of it. The Email Entity page is an amazing tool for email investigation. Whether or not the email was automatically zapped by our system, I recommend that you go ahead and block any dodgy URLs and attachments it contains. To add IOCs for each URL, select URL. Use the threat column to help identify the bad URLs from the good. Select any malicious URLs, and then select Block. Complete the wizard to add the URLs to the tenant allow block list. Now that we recognize this is bad, it'll contribute to the system. You can view or edit the blocked URL later. To do that, on the Policies and Rules page, select Threat Policies, followed by Tenant Allow Block Lists. Then select URLs. From here, you can edit or remove any blocked URL in the list. You're not done yet, however. Now we need to go looking for related emails. That's coming up. The Email Clusters tab helps find email with characteristics similar to the user-reported message. They're a tenant-oriented attempt to clean up these messages. Like the Emails tab, you see the verdict and status of each cluster. Select a cluster to see the types of threats found in it: malware, phish, high-confidence phish, or spam, the most recent delivery locations, and the original delivery locations. We've already done the investigation, which produces pending actions that remove these other messages from mailboxes. You just need to approve each. So, select Approve. To really see what emails are in each cluster, select Open in Explorer. This displays a list of emails that belong to that cluster. Once you're done investigating the incident, and there are no more active alerts, don't forget to close it out. Select Manage Incident. Then, change the status to Resolved. And choose an appropriate classification, phishing in this case. When you're done, select Save. The incident and any alerts it contains will be resolved. Going a step further, you can mark the user submission and notify the user. This is a bit of positive reinforcement that closes the loop with the user who submitted the message. Defender for Office 365 offers the tools to quickly investigate and remediate false negatives. To learn more about investigating them, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs.